always think that we need to achieve, you want to achieve, and this is really good to achieve things. It gives more confidence to the psyche, and you feel that you did something, so you feel really good about yourself. At the same time, running all the time, this really damages you. It will cause you to have pain in the lower back because of the stress. You know, the stress is the problem of so many diseases. It can cause panic attacks without you even knowing why this is happening to you. It's the light again. So you have to watch yourself, and sometimes a person would do that because they might be running away from confronting themselves. And well, you know, in life you will reach a stage where you will it will be a must for you to confront yourself. So it would be better by choice. I read in a book, it's better to kick yourself than to get kicked. Life will kick you definitely to confront yourself, because it's really good for your psyche, for your personality, for your mental health. It can be painful, I can understand. At the same time, it will be transitioning in your life. So to have the choice to actually, it's not a choice, it has to be a must. You must make time for yourself, a minimum 5 minutes, with the prayers that a Muslim does. This is amazing, you know, 5 times a day, and even sometimes more, to have this you know, being calm with God, and all what you think of is God, and to have this connection, and to be grateful, and to thank God for everything you're having, and the things that you acknowledge and the things that you don't acknowledge. This will give you a peace and being calm with yourself, and it will charge you to continue the day with a good energy, you know. But to be in the end of the day or in the middle of the day tired from running and without focusing on yourself, without taking care of yourself, it's a matter of loving yourself actually and taking care of yourself. Now, I have two courses. I did two courses on my website. One is just normal breathing technique, and the other one is holy breathing technique. I included with it, you know, names of God and words from the Quran. So you will be even charged more with the good. It takes only 20 minutes a day. For me, it was a transitioning in my life when I started doing this breathing technique, and I came up with this holy breathing technique. It made me stop taking the antidepressants. I took it for 8 months, and I was capable of stopping it with the help of God, of course, first, and then discovered that with this breathing technique, it helped me a lot, because it controls my feelings, it controls, you know, when you breathe. Breathing always has to do with the emotions within you. So when you are able to control your breathing, it means that you'll be able to control your feelings, and you won't be like in a mess feeling wise, you know, emotional wise. It's good to be aware of that, and it's really important to have at least 5 minutes a day. If you don't want to follow the course, just have 5 minutes a day, just calm and close your eyes and breathe. And if you're not able to focus on yourself or just to be relaxed, focus on the breathing that you're breathing, the air that you're breathing. How is it going inside your body and then going outside of your body? This will take your brain away from all the busy stuff that you have in your life, and it will make you calm, focusing on the breathing, having this connection with God. Definitely you will feel much better afterwards, and you will have you will feel that you're energetic, you're more enthusiastic about things, you're more passionate about things, but in a good way. Bye.